迎大家收睇《螢幕八爪魚》。雖然中年好聲音嘅比賽已經結束啦，但係佢嘅熱潮仍然未減退㗎。比賽入面有好多嘅參賽者之後都有唔錯嘅發展，就好似人氣高企嘅譚輝智咁，佢喺比賽面攞到亞軍，深受觀眾嘅歡迎。前排佢舉行嘅演唱會仲被製作成為節目添啊！
素人參賽者譚輝智喺中年好聲音二勇奪亞軍，兼觀眾最愛好聲音。呢位人氣王圓夢舉行第一次個人演唱會，傾盡全力展示天賦歌喉、招牌舞技，仲獲得一眾中二生戰友獻聲力撐。佢更加喺舞台上憑歌技藝，以第一支個人單曲感激太太一直默默付出。想支持輝智，就要留意今晚九點喺新時代電視一台播出嘅譚輝智《Fight for You》演唱會啦。
譚輝智在他的演唱會上面就全力展示了他的音樂天賦，讓一班觀眾都可以大飽耳福。其實音樂和藝術都是一樣，是一個可以幫我們表達自己和讓別人認識我們自己的方法的。接下來就帶大家去看一個叫做 Art Downtown 的活動，欣賞一下不同藝術家的精彩創作。
位於溫哥華市中心的 Art Downtown 是一個匯集不同風格藝術家的戶外活動。这个活动除了展示多位艺术家的作品，还有部分艺术家会在现场积极创作，增加互动性。现在就等活动创办人 Lisa Woodfin 和大家讲解一下 Art Downtown 这个活动的理念，还有由他介绍几位参与的艺术家给大家认识。
Art Downtown started in 2020. The inspiration came from Paris in France.There is a place in Paris that's been there for many hundreds of years where the artists are outside painting all year in the rain and the snow and everything. So we wanted to establish an area in Vancouver where people can come and watch artists paint live and also see their work, and then they can talk to the artist and learn more about how they make art and what they're doing, the materials that they use and the techniques that they use. The artists come from all over the worldAnd so there's many different styles that people can see and they can learn from the artists on what they're doing and how they're doing it. Digital art, acrylic, mixed media, all kinds of different things. So you can have a chance to talk to the artist to see what they're doing and how they're doing it. It's great for the local art scene because there's not enough galleries in Vancouver for every artist to be in.And so here they get to meet the public directly. And the artists are here to enhance the area. It looks beautiful. And all the people in the area come down and they come and they have a nice visit in the plaza and they learn from the artists. The artists are also very international. Some of them come from the island or northern BC or anywhere. And they come for only one time because they're just coming to visit Vancouver. And I would like to introduce you to Sanna Biden. She's come here from the Ukraine and she does glass art. Would you like to explain your art, what you do?
Okay, I will explain. I graduated art school many years ago. And when I was 16, I decided that I'm not Picasso. And all my life, I was a professor in finance, but 20 years ago,I came back to my art and I started to make stained glasses painting, jewelry and decorative wooden books, box with stained glasses. And now this is my life. Every day, early in the morning, I come down to my studio and come back in the evening. And this is my dream.
这是用亚克力画的，特地用了亚克力画在那个麻布包上，这是一个比较创新的一个设计，结合了就是说中西方的那些，因为我画的亚克力比较细腻的中国画的一些特色在里面。
Majority of my artwork is acrylic on canvas. All of this is my creation from my own imagination.If you get the experience to network and connect with other artists and admire their work as well, I'm really happy I took the initiative to come here.
Well, I've done a lot of mixed media art and I've done transfers with portraits before. The doors have so much meaning and I was just drawn to the doors and thought I can turn them into these paintings. People from so many countries coming here and it's just a lot of fun to talk to them about the art, and it's also very good for you because they, you know, they love my art and it's always nice to hear that. So that always pushes you forward to do more art.
Art Downtown 呢個活動會逢星期三嘅上晝11:00至到下午5:00，會喺喜士定西街855號舉行。活動每次都有唔同嘅藝術家參加展覽，大家可以期待多元化嘅藝術作品同埋即場創作。有興趣嘅朋友記得踴躍參加，到場支持本地藝術家啦！Downtown 呢個活動咧就介紹咗好多唔同嘅本地藝術家嘅精彩創作俾大家啦。咁跟住咧會帶大家去欣賞一個同樣精彩嘅活動，就係 Theater Under the Stars， 睇下今年佢哋會帶啲咩精彩嘅音樂劇表演俾大家先。Theater Under the Stars， 星空下的劇場，係温哥華一個享負盛名嘅露天音樂劇場，每年夏天就會喺史丹利公園 Melcon Bowl 度舉辦。這個劇場自1940年開始就已經成為本地文化生活的重要部分，為觀眾帶來高質素的音樂劇表演。今年他們又再次為大家帶來兩部令人期待的音樂劇 Cats 和 School of Rock。 Cats 這部經典音樂劇相信不需要多說，大家都耳熟能詳的了。而另一部 School of Rock 就是根據同名電影改編，講述一名落魄的搖滾樂手變成小學代課老師，帶領一班學生組成搖滾樂隊，追求音樂夢想的勵志故事。今次我們就邀請到 School of Rock 的導演 Tracy Power 和大家介紹一下這部音樂劇的亮點啦。
School of Rock follows the character Dewey Finn, who is an aspiring rock star in his mid-30s, so some might say maybe he should put the aspirations aside. Anyway, he gets kicked out of his band.And he can't pay his rent, so his roommates are putting the pressure on him to get a real job. And he answers a phone call for a substitute teacher position, except the position is supposed to be his roommate's, not his. So he takes the job and he shows up at Horace Green, which is a prestigious private school, to teach this class of students. AndHe finds out that his students are excellent musicians, so he creates a rock band with his students and enters them into the battle of the bands. It's inspired by a movie from the early 2000s with Jack Black, and Andrew Lloyd Webber and Julian Fellowes came together and created this musical version of the show, and it's so much fun. The music is amazing, the talent on stage is incredible. To see kids play live on stage, there's no other show like it, so it's super exciting to have it here in Vancouver. You're in the bed. You're in the bed.I think audiences will have a fantastic time. The music is so much fun, and it's just an incredible night at the theater outside in Stanley Park.
呢個夏天，無論你鍾意經典音樂劇定係現代搖滾故事，《Theater Under the Stars》星空下的劇場都會帶俾你難忘嘅觀劇體驗，千祈唔好錯過啦！無論是音樂劇定係傳統戲曲，都是表達人類情感同埋故事的媒介。咁我哋啱啱睇過嘅《Theater Under the Stars》咧，就帶俾我哋現代音樂劇嘅享受啦。咁跟住嚟咧，我哋就要轉去另一個充滿文化底韻嘅舞台，欣賞精彩嘅粵劇表演，感受一下粵劇嘅魅力啊！
振華星藝術研究社成立於1934年，係温哥華歷史最悠久嘅粵劇團體之一。佢哋致力於推廣粵劇文化，培養新一代的粵劇愛好者。今年是研究社成立的90周年，所以他們舉行了一系列以90周年為題的慶祝表演，為觀眾帶來了好幾場精彩絕倫的粵劇盛宴。現在就等我們一起去看看剛剛過去的一次精彩演出片段吧。今天的演出真的非常精彩啊！现在我们也很荣幸邀请到研究社的主席程爱琼女士，和我们分享更多关于今次90周年活动的点滴。
咁我哋雖然係離開個華埠，但係我哋鎮拿星個根始終喺華埠嘅，咁都要顧及唐人街個觀眾。故此今年咧就頭一場，我哋就喺中華文化中心演出。我先生啦，同埋我啲仔女咧，就1974年就移民嚟呢度温哥華，就好中意唱歌。咁啊，故此就有個親戚就介紹我哋入咗去鎮拿星，大家係即係假期就有啲娛樂。咁咧就中意唱歌嘅人就唱歌，中意玩音樂嘅人就玩。今次咧就因為鎮拿星咧90周年嘅社慶，所以我哋今次好隆重嘅演出，而且又有唱歌，又有粵劇，係折子戲。咁我哋今年好榮幸能夠邀請到香港名伶吳千峰先生同埋廣州星海學院兩位導師伍家輝同埋戴曉靜，就同埋我哋兩個鎮拿星嘅副社長萬芳華同埋鄭才通。咁啊伍家輝佢就帶埋佢兩位徒弟一齊嚟演出，希望大家多多捧場。
多謝程女士嘅分享，俾大家有機會了解更多關於佢哋研究社嘅故事。嚟緊佢哋將會再次為觀眾帶嚟精彩嘅演出，大家記得要密切留意，唔好錯過呢個咁難得嘅機會啦！
今次呢個 show 唔單止展現咗傳統粵劇嘅魅力，仲展示咗粵劇演員嘅精湛功底。希望大家都同我一樣，可以感受到粵劇呢份藝術嘅文化底蘊啦。阿 Fina， 你哋今個禮拜有咩精彩活動介紹俾我哋呢？
當然有啦！轉頭翻嚟，我哋有美麗傳奇30載，邀請咗2007年多倫多華裔小姐季軍 Carol 佐亮上嚟同我哋聚下舊，仲會去埋薰衣草農場體驗一個特別嘅夏日節目。廣告翻嚟繼續，熒幕八爪魚。又到我哋嘅美麗傳奇30載環節啦，娓娓華姐段段故事為你連載。今日我哋就揾嚟2007年多倫多華裔小姐季軍 Carol 佐亮，一齊話當年，講下選美難忘事。
Hello， 大家好，我是 Carol 佐亮，好久不見，很高興可以在這裡接受採訪。
Hello Carol 你好，欢迎你今天回到新时代电视和我们观众见面和接受我们的访问。相信你都很久没有跟观众朋友见过面了，不如首先讲下你的近况是怎样，最近忙着什么呢？
其实时隔这么久，我再一次回到荧幕上面真的很开心，就像你讲的真的过了很久。我最近其实刚生完宝宝不久，所以现在还在放产假。每天都过得非常的充足在很忙碌的这个过程中呢，我也很享受跟宝宝在一起的每一个时刻。
Carol 啊，咁而家睇翻当年选美嘅过程啦，有冇啲乜嘢特别印象深刻嘅咧？
其实我觉得印象很深刻的瞬间蛮多的，尤其是我想说，我当年选华姐的时候才17岁。其实就像小孩子一样，真的是年龄非常的小。通过整个选华姐的这个比赛当中，不光是跟电视台主办方这边学到了很多，也跟其他的佳丽也学到了很多，所以这个对我来说当时是比较让我记得比较清楚的。
那当时你才17岁，你觉得当时的心态跟现在的心态有什么不一样呢？
我觉得完全不一样。现在如果说让我再参加选美的话，我可能会更怕一些。那个时候年龄小，什么都不怕啊，胆子也很大，就觉得是一件很开心的事情，就只是一心真的是想要把这个show做好，然后也结识到很多很好的朋友，所以让我还是蛮开心的。
那你现在的心态，再让你参加选美的话，你会再参加吗？
我会的，其实我会的，因为我觉得这个经历是一个很好的经历，不管是在你年纪小的时候也好，还是稍微大一点的时候也好，在我的人生当中，我觉得不管什么时候能参加这么一个选美比赛，对我来说都是很好的一个经历。所以如果说我再选择的话，我也会推荐其他人也参加，如果可以的话。
Carol 啊，咁参加完选美咧，你觉得你最大嘅得着系乜嘢咧？呢一段经历对你嘅人生、对你嘅事业有冇啲咩影响咧？
啊，我觉得参加完选美之后，可以说是改变了我的人生。首先是不光是外在来看啊，比如说体态方面啊、妆发呀、造型啊这些，我当时选美完之后，我自己其实学到了很多。因为一个高中生当时感觉像是很多路都被我打开了，比如说工作之后呢，有做一些 modeling 啊、拍广告啊、演舞台剧啊这一些啊，我觉得通过选美得到的丰富的舞台的经验，让我在这一方面的工作上面给了我很大的帮助。我觉得不管是人生当中还是事业当中，觉得最大的收获在这里就是让我变得更有自信，也更勇敢地去做我想做的事情。
Carol， 好多谢你今日翻嚟接受我哋嘅访问，同埋同我哋分享你选美嘅经历。咁希望你好快又再机会有翻嚟同我哋观众朋友见面啦。
一定会的。
拜拜。
下个礼拜美丽传奇三十载会继续有好耐冇见嘅华姐接受访问，大家记得继续留意啦。如果你有興趣參選2024年多倫多華裔小姐競選嘅話，更加要留意新時代電視官方網站同各大社交平台，報名詳情就會喺8月公佈噶啦。挑戰自己就好似歷屆嘅華姐咁走出舒適圈，亦都不妨好似呢一班人咁一次又一次突破身體界限啦。
扭扭扭！咁多人喺度扭下扭下，希望可以扭出新纪录。上个礼拜六 ，Brampton 市同香港分别举办咗多人盲扭还原足感扭计式活动，希望可以挑战健力士世界纪录。
我哋系最主要咧，就系有一个理念啦，就系将我哋普通人啦，即系我哋可以睇得到所有嘅事嘅，即系我眼睛系呢一个系冇问题，但系亦都有一啲其他嘅朋友咧，佢眼睛系出现咗毛病嘅。咁我哋咧就相信咧，就系我哋系大家都系同一个社区嘅人，系有一个平等嘅地位。咁希望咧就可以由一个系眼睛健康嘅一群人啦，就同埋一啲眼睛系有问题嘅人咧，可以大家能够系融合就共處，同埋咧就可以一齊咧就建設呢個社區嘅，可以大家互相包容，係互相支持。
活動最初由一位居住喺香港嘅企業家構思同發起，佢喺2006年被診斷出患有遺傳性青光眼，並於2016年完全失明。為咗引起社會對視障群體嘅關注，他創辦了這個給健全人士和視障人士一起參與的挑戰活動，鼓勵每個人積極面對生活上的困難和挑戰。
我們現在是有120人是參加的，我們每一台也都是有一些監察員，就還有我們是健力士世界挑戰這個機構，他也都是派專人就來到我們這個場地，我們也都是有外一個專人就去香港的場地，是可以一起來到監控這個比賽的，是證明我們這個比賽是能夠達得到這個標準的。我們籌備已經超過了一年了，我們是有不同的場地，有這個賓頓市的圖書館，亦都有這個是 Milton 市的圖書館，在墨西沙加市又有不同的地方的。另外我們在東邊亦都是有各種不同的場地，是訓練一些就是他們是有興趣學這個扭計式的人士，其中一些導師是他們是眼睛有毛病，他看不到東西，但他可以教到一些是即眼睛健全的人的。
每年夏天都是安省的薰衣草季节，多伦多周边有不少薰衣草农场都会人头涌涌。在薰衣草农场，除了可以和浪漫的紫色薰衣草花田打卡，更加可以有各种好玩的娱乐项目。
位于 Creamore 小镇外围的 Purple Hill 薰衣草农场，距离多伦多大约2个钟头的车程。
This is our second annual summer festival to kick off our peak bloom. As you can see behind us, our lavender fields are in peak purple at the moment, so it's a lovely time to visit. Our lavender farm is located just outside of Creemore, Ontario, and we have over 11,000 plants.
First of all, it's a perfect place for people to take pictures and browse through the fields and enjoy the serene setting.
每年夏天，这个隐世的薰衣草农场就会欢迎大家，给游客来这里和薰衣草花田打卡之余，更加提供一系列制作薰衣草产品的活动。
Our lavender farm, we have different varieties of lavender, and with the lavender plant itself, we use that to make our own essential oil, we have dried bouquets, we also have fresh lavender when it's in season, and we use that as a base to make a lot of our hand and beauty products. If you do have your own lavender, if you take home lavender from our boutique, if it's fresh, you can hang it upside down and dry it out yourself for 2 weeks, somewhere cool and dark, and once it's dried, it lasts for about a year. So it's a beautiful way to have that experience of flowers in your home for a long period of time.
这里有不同种类的薰衣草，最常见的品种就是 Hecolam。 它的颜色比较深，而且香味浓烈，除了适合观赏，更加是制作薰衣草精油的原材料，还可以用来做烘焙材料添。至于这种 Royal Velvet 薰衣草，不怕冻又不怕干，最适合用在园艺篮。不同薰衣草都有不同的特点，你又最喜欢哪种呢？
由阿加卡恩博物馆主办的 Rhythms of Canada Festival 加拿大之声嘉年华，充满音乐、美食和欢乐。一班本地音乐人以及乐队为嘉年华带来多元化音乐，俾大家最热闹嘅表演啦！
早前国庆日长周末，阿加卡恩博物馆举办咗一个名为 Rhythms of Canada Festival 加拿大之声嘉年华活动，除咗邀请嚟自大多伦多地区嘅唔同音乐表演团体参与，更加设立各种家庭娱乐项目，令大家可以尽情享受亲子时光。
I'm so pleased to welcome Toronto's audiences to Rhythms of Canada Festival at the Aga Khan Museum at the Smiley Centre in the Aga Khan Park. It's a weekend full of family, hands-on fun, music, food, artisan vendors. We have exciting performances happening here in our park stage as well as inside in the Nanji Family Foundation Auditorium. We have also exciting family activities and storytelling and hands-on activities. We have inside the Aga Khan Museum, our collection is on view in the permanent gallery. Additionally, we have fun family activities happening inside the museum, in our atrium, in our education center. So there's lots to do for people all day, all weekend long.
正如主办方所讲，这里室内、室外的活动都多罗罗。首先有原住民音乐表演为活动拉开序幕。在博物馆的教育中心，大家有机会参与不同族裔的文化活动，还可以试下写中国书法添。虽然天气就麻麻地，不过活动一样吸引不少人，一家大小一起参与，感受热闹的国庆日气氛的。
轻轻松松，唱唱跳跳，令人回心微笑的不单止是音乐，更加是大家在嘉年华营造的气氛。Nina， 呢份熱鬧，相信你都可以感受到啊！
冇錯啊，音樂同埋節日嘅氣氛的確會令人心情愉快噶。希望呢份歡樂喺電視機前面嘅你哋都可以感受到啦。好啦，咁今日嘅節目時間就差唔多啦，我哋下星期同樣時間再見啦，拜拜。